Preconceived Notions, page 7. At the risk of anticipating too much of the later argument, it might be best even at this point to question whether all unification of purpose or character is religious. As one example of conversion, Pratt chooses the experience of a certain Ardigo, who renounced the Roman Catholic priesthood to become a positivistic scientist. Now, this is no doubt a conversion of a sort, but is it a religious conversion? Of course, the answer to this question depends on one's definition of a religion. Pratt defends his choice of examples on the ground that he has not permitted preconceived notions derived from Christian theology to influence him, presumably to choose as examples of conversion only those instances which accord with Christian theology would be to forfeit the claim to scientific objectivity. At the same time, although Pratt may not have selected his material from the standpoint of any one of the well-known world religions, he nonetheless has made his selection on the basis of other preconceived principles, which can be thought of as his private religion. From a logical standpoint, it is equal whether one's assumptions are philosophical or theological, Christian or not. If it is reprehensible to operate on Christian presuppositions, is it any less so on other presuppositions? The only difference would seem to be that the writer with Christian principles is probably more aware of the fact, while the scientific writer sometimes claims that he has no preconceived notions at all. In other words, Pratt, attempting to avoid the bias of Christian view of conversion, does not seem to be aware of his own bias in assuming Ardigo's conversion was a religious conversion and that the essence of religion is the unification of character.